technical communication bridges the gap between knowledge and meaning.
Having that communication skill, the ability to refactor something so that other people can understand it, that's a very important skill.
Society is getting more technical, and so I think the opportunity for entry-level roles, I think, is very, very strong.
When I got into technical communication, someone with just an English degree could do that, but that's not really possible anymore. As a manager of technical writing, I ran into a lot of people who were changing careers, people who were maybe good at writing, liked technical information, but they maybe didn't have the credentials to get a job as a technical writer. So for people who are changing careers, one of the ways that they can make themselves more marketable and credible is to go through the Writing Studies certificate program.
I think it's also going to be helpful to anybody who's entering the job market right now, because again, so much of the work that we do is communicating.
Everyone talks about how valuable communication is, and it's true. Fundamentally, that ability to communicate clearly, effectively, and to do so understanding your audience and being able to tailor your messages to those audiences, those are skills that can be used in just about any field.
I've hired many, many hundreds of technical writers, and a lot from the Writing Studies program. And I feel like those students came very well prepared to really think through what they were doing.
I think the certificate program and the master's program, both of them, are great examples of things that you can do to deepen your skills and be able to bring some knowledge and kind of current tools and approaches to the company that you're working at already.
The online graduate certificate in technical communication program provides graduate level instruction for working professionals and students to enhance their knowledge and skills in technical communication.
I became a technical communicator when I understood all that goes into making great pieces of work for end users. I learned that graphic design exists. I learned that project management exists. I learned the art of persuasion. And those things were really interesting to me.
That rhetorical kind of base of the program is really around understanding how to persuade people in an ethical manner, truly understanding who your audience is, and being able to tailor that message to those audiences' needs is critical. That element around persuasion, I thought, was a really effective part of the program that I use almost every day in my job.
I use my technical editing skills quite a lot. I would say of the classes that I took, the information design class has been very, very useful because it really helps me find ways to present information in a way that people can immediately grasp. You know, if you can present your information in a chart or some sort of an infographic or as a heat map or some other way rather than just plain words, I think people really get the message.
Another important course is writing with digital technologies, because that is really paramount in publications and technical communication today, because we're publishing in so many different mediums that increasingly most writers in larger organizations are working with content management systems. They're writing for translatability, and they really need to be able to use a lot of different technologies to do that writing. I always had all of the writers who worked for me take some kind of coursework in intercultural communications, partly because the world is so global now, most businesses are global. Our colleagues may be working in other countries, and our customers certainly frequently are.
It is not necessary to take the GRE to apply to this program. Also, all 5 certificate courses can be transferred into our Master of Science program.
The great thing about that is that that's essentially year one of the master's program. So you can stop at the end of that certificate program, or you can actually go on and continue your education to be able to complete the master's degree as well.
As a graduate student, you will have the opportunity to work with the Technical Communication Advisory Board, a group of business leaders who can provide you with pathways to experiential learning opportunities, such as networking, mentoring, and internships.
When I was in the program, very few classes were online. Technical editing, for example, was online, but pretty much the rest of my classes were in person.
All of those courses are online now. So if you're in another job at a coffee shop or wherever, it's very easy for someone to do that work at night or whenever they're not working.
The certificate program being entirely online is a very exciting opportunity for people who may not have a program of the stature of the University of Minnesota close enough for them to be able to take advantage of that. And so whether you're just across town and you're working full time and you want to be able to fit that into a busy schedule, or you're across the country, or you're in a different country.
It's a little bit more flexible in terms of being able to make the online class suit your schedule. That certainly would have helped me when I went through the program, and I really do hope it helps other students as they go through it now.